If I want to add the same shape multiple times on the screen, I'll double-click on it. I add the first one, and then I still have my crosshairs to add a second one. And I still have those crosshairs. To get out of that, I can hit Escape. I can go down and hit the Select button, or I can just click on another object. Now I want to add a puzzle piece. I'm going to hold down Shift to give me the default dimensions. And if I click on it, we see that the puzzle piece outline turns to a dashed line instead of a solid line for just a brief second while I have that mouse button down. But nothing else really happens. We can change that by clicking this button right here, Rotation Mode after clicking Object. If that's turned on, now when I click it, after it's selected, my handles turn from blue squares to red circles. And if I put my cursor over that top middle and move it, it skews the object. I'm using Control Z to go back, and it works on the side the same way. I can skew my object. But if I go over one of these corners, it rotates my object. And we can see that it's rotating around this circle here. I can move this circle to around the page or even off the page. Now when I move it, that it still rotates around that rotation point. Let's do the same thing with one of these rectangles. I'm going to move this over a little bit. Click it again. Now I'm going to move this rotation point to this corner. And I can move this from any of these other corners. It works the same way. I can rotate it around. And if I hold down Shift, it moves in 15 degree increments. So if I want it 90 degree difference, I just hold down Shift. And I can move it back from this corner, from this corner, and I can use any of the other three because it rotates my object around the rotation point. And if I click it again, it goes back into selection mode. So clicking on a selected object just toggles on and off the rotation mode. Now let's select two shapes. And we see that we didn't quite select that puzzle piece in that selection because I need to select all of the fill handles to get it in the selection. Let's try that again. And now we got it. Another way to do that would be to click on the first object, hold down Shift, and click on the second object. To rotate both these objects, I need to have the four-sided arrow. And that only happens when I'm over a filled area. If I'm within the selected area and not over a filled area and I click, it doesn't work. Let's add an unfilled rectangle. Put it in there. I'm going to hold down Shift, click the next one, and again. Now all three are in here. And when I'm inside the unfilled rectangle, I'm back to the arrow. I need to be on the line to have the four-sided arrow. If I click that, now we get the red circle fill handles, and I can rotate these. I'm going to hold down Shift and click it again to get the green fill handles, and now I can move it. One last thing about rotation mode. When I'm in rotation mode, if I hold down Control and grab one of those corners, it allows me, I've got to let up Control, hold down again, to make a copy and rotate them around that same rotation point. And now if I hold down Control and Shift, it's allowing me to move this in the 15 degree increment. So if I was making a clock or something, I can make sure that my object is 90 degrees. Holding down shift and control again, moving it down to the bottom. But if I just hold down control, I can place it anywhere I want in that arc.